Champ Kind Sports. Brick Tamlin, weather. Reporter in the field, Brian Fantana. And five-time Emmy Award-winning anchor.
We interrupt our program to bring you this important message.
We welcome you to Archbishop Bergan in beautiful Fremont, Nebraska. Although this is a show about secret lives, there is no secret that Archbishop Bergan is home of some of the greatest students and families in all of the history of time. With all that is happening around Bergan, it's hard to believe teachers have a secret life at all. We had a chance to catch up with some of the students to see if they had any insight into the secret lives of teachers.
I think Mrs. Wheel's favorite animal is a paddlefish.
I think Mrs. Wheel's favorite animal is an elephant.
I think Mrs. Wheel's favorite animal is a giraffe.
Paramecium.
My favorite animal is the giant tortoise.
Stargirl.
Touching Spirit Bear. The Outsiders.
My favorite book is Travel Team by Mike Lupica because it's about basketball and it focuses on somebody who's the underdog and what it means to be a small player but yet a mighty player in the end.
Sheboygan, Wisconsin.
North Korea.
Tibet.
Kalamazoo.
Tama. My favorite place to vacation is anywhere with my entire family.
Titanic.
Caddyshack 2.
Howard the Duck.
Dumb and Dumber.
Duh, Highlander. It's the greatest movie ever. The faces
fade. My favorite movie to watch over and over is Singing in the Rain with Gene Kelly and Debbie Reynolds.
The first student we had an opportunity to talk with was junior softball player Tessa Krakenbauer. Let's check in on that conversation with Tessa and see what she has to say. After a 7-23 season last year, the Fremont Tigers softball team has more than doubled last year's win total, with a current record of 17-12. What has been the key to this year's turnaround?
I feel we work better as a team, and everybody loves everybody on and off the field.
What has been the most memorable moment of this season?
When we beat the number 5th seed, Lincoln Southwest, a couple days ago.
With districts at the end of this week, what's it going to take to earn a state berth?
I feel like we need to go in there having confidence and keep our eyes on the prize and stay focused.
The real reason we brought you here, Tessa, was to ask you a question about the secret lives of teachers. What do you think Mr. Maroff listens to at the end of the day, after that final bell rings?
Probably Justin Bieber.
Why do you think that?
Because who doesn't love Justin Bieber?
You got AC/DC, Thunderstruck.
Beatles. Backstreet Boys.
Beach Boys.
Justin Bieber.
Garth Brooks.
Eminem, The Real Slim Shady.
Nick Jonas, Jealous.
The Cheetah Girls.
Break Stuff by Limp Bizkit.
Baby by Justin Bieber.
The Jonas Brothers.
Britney Spears, Hit Me Baby One More Time. Twice, I mean
maybe a couple of Wrecking Ball by Miley Cyrus.
I came in like a wrecking ball. I never hit so hard.
Some things you just can't unsee. We had a chance to catch up with junior cross country runner Evan Steed. Evan, can you tell us just a little bit about this year's cross country team?
Yeah, you know, we got a lot of really good runners out there this year in middle school all the way up to high school. In middle school, we've got Nathan, we've got Jaden, and even in high school, we've got Katie Slicer and Nick the Boy Chin Cannon. You know, we just got a lot of really good runners that have some real chances to make things happen.
With conference cross country coming up this Friday, Evan, what's it going to take for us to come home with some hardware?
You know, we just got to put our minds to it. It's all just a mental thing. We just got to remember to close that gap, stride out on the flat grass, and just remember, it's a mental thing.
Josie's on a vacation far away. Come around and talk it over.
Well, that's an easy one. The Real Housewives of Orange County.
Girl's a little bit older.
The Office.
I think he likes to watch Curious George.
Favorite TV show would be That's a Raven.
Probably has to be South Park.
Probably Gossip Girl.
That's a hard one. Jersey Shore.
Law and Order.
Next up, we check in with the girls' golf team for the inaugural season. Here we are with Michaela Acker. What have you learned about competing in varsity tournaments?
Competing in a varsity meet, you have to go out there and try your hardest. And if you make a mistake, it's fine. Just go out there on a big bang on the next one. I think that Emma's really excited about State. It's exciting because we've never had a girls' golf team, so it's cool that it's our first year. We already have one going to State. It's a big deal. Go, Emma.
The last question I want to ask you. We're here really about the secret lives of teachers. What sport do you think your teacher, Mr. Folkers, really likes to play when no one's watching?
I think he likes playing indoor hockey by himself, because he can't lose.
Basketball.
Badminton.
Women's water polo.
Paper football. Something's changed,
it ain't hard. Oh, Mr. Folkers, great guy. If you'll need to be brutally honest, double dutch, or hula hoops in the weight room, definitely.
Have a good day, kids.
We next check in with Alyssa Menlik and the volleyball team. After finishing with a 14-17 record a year ago, what has sparked the team to its current 13-5 record?
I think our team bond really helps us to help communicate and just to be together, and we work well together, so that helps us win. Yeah.
With the conference tournament coming up this weekend, districts right around the corner, what's it going to take to get a little bit of momentum and make it to that state tournament?
Working together and just working hard and keeping the eye on the prize.
So, Alyssa, what do you think Coach Painter likes to do when he has free time?
Winning.
Dabbing.
Eating.
It definitely has 7th
grade. 2K17.
He likes to cheer for the Nebraska Cornhuskers.
We'll be good!
Sleeping.
Fighting crime.
Exploring other cultures.
I'd have to say photobombing.
Why is that?
I don't know.
Our last interview here at Bergen is with senior football player Brant Ritter. The Fighting Knights currently sit at 3-3 after being hit hard by the injury bug. What's the motivation for this young team right now?
I think that we're all just motivated to go out there and give the fans a good show, and I don't know, Bergen's traditionally a winning football team, and just want to go out there and make the alumni happy.
After losing a couple of close games early in the year, it appears that winning the district title is the only way to punch a ticket to the state playoffs. What's it going to take to accomplish that goal?
We just need to go out there every game and play our hardest and do the best that we can and leave it all out on the field.
After watching the football team this year, I've been quite confused with the long play calls from Mr. Bruce on the sideline. Can you give me an example of, like, one of these calls?
I don't know. All right. Brick, bear, brick, zoom, flame, flash,
That's quite the play call. Last question. What do you think special teams coach, Coach Moore, likes to do at the end of the day?
You know, I don't really know. I always like to think he was a gourmet chef or something, but I don't know for sure. Just a small
town girl. Spending time with family.
He likes to eat crab rangoons.
Save the day.
Yeah, break the law. He likes to break the law.
Yeah. Dress in her ghost clothes.
Looking good.
I think they like to watch professional wrestling reruns. Oh yeah!
Mr. Moore likes to sit in his front yard and yell at kids that drive too fast past his house.
Zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off.